So today my topic is basic nature of indirect taxes applicable earlier. This video I have prepared mainly for those people who lack basic knowledge on taxes. So this is a must to watch before you understand the need for GST implementation and the basic GST model. So let's go ahead. So first is excise duty, central tax, that is tax levied by the central government. Earlier we had excise duty, but now it got replaced with GST. So what is the basic nature of excise duty? It's a tax charged on manufacture of goods recovered from buyer on its sale. So the manufacturer had to pay this excise duty to the central government for the goods manufactured by him, and he would recover this from his own customer on its sale. So finally, the buyer has to bear the excise duty burden when they buy the manufactured products. Second is CST, central tax, same
tax levied by the central government.
What is the basic nature? Tax charged on interstate sale between states of goods at each stage of supply chain, levied by the central government and collected by the state government of origin state, that is place from where goods move. For example, a dealer in Karnataka is selling his product to a customer in another state, say Odisha. This customer might be a retailer or a final consumer. So he would collect CST and pay this CST to the state government of the origin state. Origin state in our example is Karnataka, that is place from where goods move. So finally, tax would be collected by the Karnataka government. Service tax, central tax, basic nature, tax charged on sale of services. Now it got replaced with one single tax, that is GST. So earlier for services we had separate tax, that is service tax. Fourth is countervailing duty and special countervailing duty. What was this? It was an additional import duty charged on imports. Now it has got replaced with GST. So even after implementation of GST, we still have custom duty, that is import duty. However, additional import duty or additional custom duty has got replaced with GST. So this additional import duty was charged by the government with an objective to raise the price of the imported products, which will protect the domestic industries. Fifth is VAT, state tax, that is tax collected by the state government. Tax charged on intrastate sale within state of goods at each stage of supply chain. So basically it was tax charged on sale of goods within the states. So now it got replaced with GST. A seller would recover VAT from his buyer or customer and then pay to the state government.
Sixth is luxury tax, again a state tax. Tax charged on sale of luxury goods and services, example spas, lodging, houses. So actually, if you go and stay in a luxury hotel like 5-star, 7-star, the rent you pay for that hotel will include luxury tax. However, luxury tax was not applicable on food items. Food being a necessity of life, luxury tax was not applicable on it. So now this luxury tax has got replaced with GST. Seventh is entertainment tax, state tax. Tax charged on commercial entertainments like movie tickets, exhibition, etc. So now this tax got replaced with GST.
And eighth is end tax, was tax charged by recipient state on movement of goods from one state to another. By recipient state, we mean the state to which goods are moved. So the state government of the recipient state would charge the entry tax. However, now this entry tax has been replaced by GST. Ninth is advertisement tax, state tax. It was tax charged on advertisers for display of advertisements like hoarding, slide, etc. So now it got replaced with GST. So the advertisers had to pay advertisement tax, which they would collect from their own customer. Last two points are central surcharges and cesses related to supply of goods and services, and state surcharges and cess related to supply of goods and services. So what was surcharge actually? Surcharge being additional charge or tax charged on existing tax, whereas cess
was a tax charged by a government to raise fund for a specific purpose. Example, Krishi Kalyan says, Swachh Bharat says, Education says, etc. So these are few cesses. Krishi Kalyan says and Swachh Bharat says were actually paid by a person in addition to service tax. So now all surcharges and cesses related to supply of goods and services, both central and state, have got replaced with GST. So that's all. It was a briefing done on all the indirect taxes applicable earlier.
Hope so you liked my video. Thank you.